The Raspberry Pi Pico 2 doesn't just promise more power, it brings 4 cores to the table, with 2 ARM and 2 RISC-V cores. But how much faster is it really than the original Pico? I ran the same benchmark on both boards, same code, same conditions. The results were surprising, and they reveal a lot about what this new chip can actually do. Before we dive into the benchmark, let's take a quick look at what we are comparing. The original Raspberry Pi Pico features a dual-core ARM Cortex M0 Plus processor running at 133 MHz by default when using the Arduino IDE. It comes with 264 KB of SRAM and 2 MB of flash memory and no hardware floating point unit. It is a simple, efficient board that has become a favorite for hobbyists and embedded developers alike. The Pico 2, on the other hand, uses a completely different chip. It can boot into either 2 ARM Cortex M33 cores or 2 RISC-V cores. By default, when using the Arduino IDE, it runs at 150 MHz. It includes 512 KB of SRAM and 4 MB of flash memory, twice as much as the original. And if you are using the M33 cores, you also get a hardware FPU, which can significantly accelerate floating point math. So on paper, the Pico 2 should be noticeably faster, newer architecture, more RAM, and a floating point unit. But to really understand the difference, we need to run the exact same code on both boards to see how they perform under the same conditions. Each board will run the same Arduino sketch to calculate the value of Pi using 100,000 iterations of a basic approximation algorithm. To keep things simple and closer to real-world usage, the code runs on a single core, since most makers don't take advantage of multi-core programming anyway. The result will be shown on a 1.8-inch color TFT screen. For the first round of testing, each board will run at its default frequency, 133 MHz for the original Pico and 150 MHz for the Pico 2. I am going to power both boards at the same time using the same power bank to keep things fair. As you can see, the Pico 2 completed the task in about 3.6 seconds, while the original Raspberry Pi Pico needed 5.6 seconds. So in this test, the Pico 2 is around 35% faster, just by switching to a newer architecture and running at its slightly higher default clock speed. That is a noticeable improvement, especially for a drop-in replacement. But don't leave the video yet. Wait until you see what happens when I switch to the RISC-V cores. Then I set the Pico 2 to run at the same 133 MHz as the original. Even then, it completed the task in just 3.9 seconds, still about 30% faster. That shows how much of a difference the improved architecture and the hardware FPU can make, even at identical clock speeds. In my opinion, this is quite impressive. The Pico 2 uses ARM Cortex M33 cores, which are a big step up from the Cortex M0 Plus cores in the original. They support more advanced instructions, better pipelining, and include a built-in floating point unit, which really helps in number-heavy tasks like this one. In short, they can do more work per cycle, and it shows in the results. Next, I tried overclocking both boards using the Arduino IDE. On the original Pico, the highest stable frequency I could reach was 240 MHz, which brought the time down to 3.98 seconds. The Pico 2, on the other hand, ran smoothly at 300 MHz and finished the benchmark in just 2.8 seconds. That's a big jump in performance. Now, let's test the Pico 2 using its RISC-V cores. At the default 150 MHz, it completed the benchmark in 8.8 seconds. I also ran it at 133 MHz to match the original Pico, and it needed 9.9 seconds. For comparison, the original Pico at 133 MHz completed the same task in 5.6 seconds. That means the RISC-V cores were about 77% slower at the same frequency, and still 57% slower even with a 150 MHz clock. I overclocked the RISC-V cores to 240 MHz, which brought the time down to 6.3 seconds, much better, but still 58% slower than the original Pico running at 240 MHz, which completed the benchmark in just 4 seconds. This confirms that for floating point heavy tasks, the ARM Cortex M0 Plus, even without a hardware FPU, performs significantly better than the RISC-V cores on the Pico 2. Let's now take a look at power consumption. At 130 MHz, the Raspberry Pi Pico and the display draw about 46 mA, and when overclocked to 240 MHz, they draw around 60 mA. At the low end, running the Pico at 50 MHz brings the current down to 32 mA. In comparison, the Pico 2, together with the same display, draws about 42 mA at 150 MHz, 55 mA at 300 MHz, and 34 mA at 50 MHz. All measurements were taken at 5 volts during the benchmark. If we use the RISC-V cores, the current draw of the Pico 2 is about the same. So, in this simple benchmark, the results are clear. The Raspberry Pi Pico 2 is not just faster than the original Pico, it's also more energy efficient when running on its ARM Cortex M33 cores. The combination of a more advanced architecture, higher clock speeds, and a hardware FPU gives it a clear edge in floating point performance. However, when switching to RISC-V cores, performance drops off sharply, despite the higher clock speed. That's likely due to several factors. The RISC-V cores lack a hardware floating point unit. The RISC-V instruction set architecture isn't as optimized for this type of workload as ARM, and the compiler tool chains for embedded RISC-V are still relatively immature. In other words, the potential is there, but for now, the ARM cores remain the better choice for number-crunching tasks like this. So there you have it. What do you think about these results? Let me know in the comments. But the story doesn't end here. I'll be putting the Pico 2 head-to-head against two serious contenders, the ESP32-S3 and the ESP32-P4. Stay tuned, because that one is going to be a lot more intense.